शांति, वेरी सॉफ्ट, ओम शांति। द टॉपिक व्हिच आई विल बी टेकिंग अप नाउ इज एक्सपीरियंसिंग एंजेलिक स्टेज, because only when we are in that stage we really feel the closeness of Baba, or we can say Bap Dada, because Brahma Baba is in his angelic form, Shiv Baba is in his incorporeal form. And therefore, to experience Shiv Baba and Brahma Baba, we need to experience the angelic stage. Then it becomes easy for us to experience the incorporeal stage. And as Baba says, that the aim of confluence age is attaining angelic stage. The total aim of this path of knowledge is to attain mukti and jivan mukti, liberation in life and liberation from life, returning home and coming to the golden age. But before that, we have to attain the angelic stage. We cannot go back home or go to the golden age until we attain angelic stage. And once that angelic stage experienced, returning home, going to the new world, isn't difficult at all. It is like stamped. It's like you get the visa. You know, until you get the visa, you don't know whether you'll be able to visit that country or not. Visa is important. And after you've got the visa, line is clear. Now it's up to you when you want to go, which date you want to depart. So Baba also says, to return home, to return, to go to the new world, you first need to attain the angelic stage. You cannot go directly to Paramdham. You have to go via subtle regions. And in the subtle regions, there will definitely be two types of experiences. One is that Baba will be welcoming you with open arms, because Brahma Baba is in the subtle regions. He will welcome you with open arms, because Baba says, then you will become my companions, and we will return home together. But then the other experience of subtle regions is the punishment, Dharamrajpuri, also is in that region. And in our subtle form, we will experience punishment. But then we will not go as companions of Baba, like Baba said in today's Murli also, but we will go as the marriage procession. So in the scriptures, they show marriages of everyone, you know, of Radhe, of Krishna, of Sri Ram. But then the great significance of marriage is the marriage of Shiva. Of course, they show him as Shankar, and they say that when Shiva married Parvati and then went home, how behind them the procession was endless. And in that endless procession, all the 8.4 million species were there, you know. We speak about 8.4 million species. Not only deities, but also, they say, wandering spirits, evil spirits, you know, all that. I mean, everything they show. All the species, the animals, I mean, anything you could think of were all in there, in the procession. So what does that signify? In no other deity's marriage they show like that. Only in Shiva's marriage. They call it Shiv Ki Barat. The big marriage procession of Shiva. And they say that many were so afraid to see that procession, because in that procession they were all, you know, the big, the spirits, the wandering spirits also, and it was very, very strange procession. All types of faces, all types of species, but then they only followed. But Parvati was with Shiva, and she was in that intoxicated stage. Therefore, we always show Parvati in intoxicated stage. When Shankar and Parvati, of course, we say we are all the Parvatis experiencing the intoxication because we are with Shiva. You know, in India, many people question us, why didn't you get married? He said, we're already married. He said, sure, are you married? Then who's your husband? He said, Shiva is my husband. Shiva is my husband. Then they start wondering, what does she mean, Shiva is my husband? So we're already married. And we will go as companion of Shiva back to Paramdham. And then from there, of course, Baba says, I will send you to the golden age. But before that, we will be in the subtle regions. And then also Baba says that you will go number wise. It's not that all together. In the procession too is number wise. Because when they show the, when they narrate the procession, they say first there were deities, the royal deities, you know, different types of deities. Even deities, they say 33 crores, so like how many? 330 million deities all in that procession. And then humans, and then animals, birds, whatever, all the souls in their different species form. Everyone following, and at the end were the wandering spirits, the evil spirits in that procession. So Baba says that who can become the companion of God? The one who becomes like Brahma Baba and Shiv Baba. So you heard a lot about that, but then before that, we have to attain that angelic stage. And the angelic stage is not that we will attain it only at the end. Baba says you can experience that angelic stage whilst performing every action. So, how does Baba define an angel? An angel is the one whose feet don't touch the ground. The feet are always above the ground. And the Hindi word is farishta. The Urdu word actually is farishta. Farsh se rishta nahi. No relationship with the ground. Always above the ground. So, what does that mean? Baba says it is the ground, your feet are your intellect. So the feet of your intellect should always be above this physical gross pull. So who can be above the ground? The one who is light. Therefore, you know, when we have petrol. The aviation fuel is the lightest fuel of all. We cannot put diesel or, you know, car petrol in the aeroplane. I remember going to one of these refineries where they refine crude oil, you know, in Assam. There are big wells of oil from where oil comes. It, of course, in Middle East countries, it's there, but even in India, we do get oil in Assam. So, in the Northeast countries. So, I had the opportunity to visit one of the refineries there. And I had to give a lecture there. So I wanted to know, how is that crude oil refined, you know? And it was so interesting to see how it was refined. Because there are so many byproducts of that oil. So many. The first byproduct is tar, you know, tar which you use to make roads so heavy, so black, so dirty looking like that. And so that was the first product. So I saw how that product was coming out. Then they took me to another section because that petrol, that oil went to another place, another area. And there the second product was wax. Wax, you know, wax is also a part of that crude oil. And I saw, then they said that from this wax we make so many beautiful candles, you know, wax candles. So nothing is actually wasted. Everything is used. There are so many byproducts. And the last byproduct, they say it is the 16th byproduct. I mean, the last one, after all the 15 byproducts have been removed. But all are useful products. They're coming out of their crude oil. And then the last one, the highest one, was aviation fuel, which is used in aeroplanes. Because if in an aeroplane heavy petrol is used, then it can't fly, you know, it takes weight. So that oil is so fine, it's as good as water, you know, if you really touch it, it's like even more fine than water. So light it is. And water is at least a little bit heavy, you know, when you hold it, you can know that it is water. But that refined, the highest refined fuel, what Baba said, double refined. So that's the aviation fuel. Only that is used for aeroplanes. So Baba says that when can you become an angel? When you become double refined, you know. Double light. When Baba says double refined, it means double light. That's double refined. So double light, only then you can become an angel. And when we describe the meaning of double light, we say light in weight and light in form. That's the meaning of double light. So like a soul is a light in form, it is point of light. And it is also very light in weight. So before that, the angelic stage also has to be very light in weight and light in form. Only then the incorporeal form can be experienced. So angelic form also is double light. And when we say double light means although it's the form of a body, but then that body is made of light. Double light in an incorporeal form is just point of light. But being in the physical form, we can experience that angelic stage whilst performing actions too. Maybe for experiencing incorporeal form, we have to sit and detach ourselves completely, be free from all pulls, you know, everything of this physical world. Then we can experience that point of light form. But the angelic form can be experienced even while performing actions. Once Baba asked a question, that can you experience incorporeal form while performing actions? Or you need to sit to experience that state? What do you think? What do you think? Nidhi? Niti? What do you think? Can you experience incorporeal form even in first coming into action, or you have to sit in order to experience that incorporeal form? Those who say you have to sit and experience, you can't do it while it's moving, walking, you know, all that. They raise their hand. No? And those who think that they can experience, what did I say first? Can or not? So those who think that they can experience incorporeal stage whilst performing actions, they raise their hand? No? You can, okay. And those who think you have to sit and experience, they raise their hand? Acha? The two opinions. Well, to some extent you can. But in order to really have a deep experience of incorporeal stage, you have to be completely free from any karma, you know, karmic bondage. Usually when Baba says karmati stage, it means not to be pulled by the fruit of karma, not even think what fruit you are going to get. Just do the karma and be detached. That is karmatit stage, beyond the pull of karma. Not that we don't do karma, we do karma and then we can go beyond. We do karma and then go beyond. That is like going closer to karmatit stage. And that stage could also be the angelic stage. It can also be very close to our incorporeal stage. Because in the incorporeal stage we have merged everything in that point of light. Like Shiv Baba is a point of light, the whole ocean is in that point of light. Knowledge, peace, love, ocean of all these qualities Baba is, and that is all merged in that point of light. So Baba says, you can experience that stage in whilst moving around, but then maybe it won't last long, but then you can become completely detached and go beyond the pull of the body, beyond the pull of the physical surroundings, beyond the pull of any type of attraction, completely above. Like we see how people, they go in space. So how in space that pull of earth is finished. The gravitational pull is no longer there of the earth. So too Baba says that whilst being in the body, can you experience that point of light form, which it may not be very easy, but angelic form if you can experience, then you are very close to that incorporeal form. It's like before reaching Mount Abu, you have reached Abu Road, or you reached Ahmedabad, so you are very close to Mount Abu. So incorporeal stage is very close if you reach the angelic form. But then in order to experience that angelic form, Baba says from time to time, experience the stage of being detached. Baba gives the example of a tortoise. What does a tortoise do? A tortoise, how it walks, it takes out its limbs, hands, legs, head, and walks slowly, slowly, slowly. And then when it sees some obstacle coming in the way, something, some obstruction, it just withdraws. So Baba too teaches us how to withdraw. You know, once there was an article that which living creature lives the longest, and the answer was tortoise. A tortoise can live for 500 years, you know. Animals, birds, how long their life is, okay, humans 100 years, 150 years, not more than that in any physical body. But a tortoise can live for 500 years and still go strong. Although it will become very old, but it can go strong. I saw one tortoise, I don't remember which country I was in, maybe I was in Vietnam or some country I went, or Thailand, I'm not, because I haven't been to so many countries, but they took me to that place, and they said the longest living tortoise. Does anybody know where it is? But it is there, in somewhere in Asia. So, and then so big it was, so big, so huge, and the shell was also so huge, and it was inside the tank, you know, in the water tank. So, and all description about it, how it survived all these years, 500 years, is not a small thing. And then there was mention of why tortoises can live that long. Because their, in their life, there are two things. One thing is that they learn to withdraw. And they are very slow, much slow. And they know how to withdraw. So because they know how to withdraw and they are slow, they can live that long. You know, people who are very fast, very stressful, they can get a stroke or they can get a heart attack. Because the body can't take in, you know, when somebody is too much in stress or too much in anger. Anything can happen to your brain, veins, the arteries and the heart arteries. Immediately it can be attack or stroke. So physical body can't bear all that anyway. And therefore the tortoise is beyond all that. It knows how to withdraw in the second. And also its inner, system it also works very slow. The system in the body also, all the systems work very slow. That is one aspect. And the other is that it can withdraw. It eats very little. It doesn't eat much. I asked, what does it eat? So just leaves, that's all. Only leaves, that's what it eats. So, and if it eats just leaves, not anything else, then it can survive even longer. So it was a big description. So Baba gives the example of tortoise to us. In every Shiva temple, they show a tortoise next to the bull, you know, just behind the bull. They show a tortoise and then the bull, and that's a chariot of Shiva, and then the temple of Shiva, the Shivling. So before you reach the bull, you have to become like a tortoise. So tortoise stage is like angelic stage. And Brahma Baba attained that stage very quickly. We say 69 means now how many years? 44 years. So 44 years ago Brahma Baba attained that angelic stage. How did he attain that angelic stage? We could feel it, you know, how he was attaining angelic stage. Like you can see from Baba's Sakar Murlis. Before, Baba used to pay attention to everything, you know. Whatever is going on the yagya, of course, Mama was responsible. Anything would happen, Baba would say, go to Mama. That was there. But also, Baba used to give advice. Baba used to also help souls in deciding what business to do, how to take care of the family, their property, all that, the physical things of this world. Baba used to advise in many ways. But gradually we could see Baba became so detached. So detached in the sense that even whilst hearing, we could feel that he's not hearing, you know, we could hear. Because I remember one instance with Sakar Baba, that how one sister went to Baba and she started talking a lot and about the service she had done in her area. Baba, I did this, Baba, I did that, Baba, you know, Baba, you know, Baba, Baba, Baba. Those people were so happy and they liked everything, and then they want to help in different ways. So Baba, you know, like she was praising herself in the name of praising service, she was praising herself. And Baba realized, no, this is too much. So, and she had already written in a letter, big letter, many pages letter, in which she had written all the news of service which she did in her place. So when Baba saw that, now it's enough. So Baba was very sweet. He said, child, you have written all that in the letter, haven't you? She said, yes Baba, I wrote everything in the letter, Baba, everything. You know, again she was so excited to tell everything to Baba. Baba said, so Baba knows. Baba knows. Huh? Baba was very sweet in commenting, because Baba could also say, enough, enough, I don't want to hear more. You know, you can just say straight away. That person can feel insulted because I stop him from saying something which I'm not interested in. Some people even say, please, please, enough, I don't want to hear more, I've got no time. But Baba very sweetly said, child, Baba knows. Baba knows. And the moment Baba said that, she was so quiet, she stopped. She was like, not that she was shocked, but then she realized that Baba's stage was so high and she was so low. In that low stage, and she was trying to tell Baba, show off maybe to Baba. And also, you know, Manohar Indra Dadi was relating once that in 1968, when Vishwakishore Bhau, who was very, very close, right hand of Brahma Baba, so how in 68 he left the body, and he was in Bombay at that time, he underwent a big operation, but then he didn't survive for long. That time even medicine was, not that that good as today. It was in the year 1968. So he left the body in. And before that, the Vishwakishore went through a lot of pain. There was a lot of pain. And Baba was being informed that, Baba, he is in a lot of pain. So how whole night Baba sat and did give sakash to that soul. And then in the morning, Baba... Dadi Prakash Mani was in Bombay, and Dadi phoned Baba. Baba, he had good rest. He didn't feel the pain. But actually Baba was giving him sakash so that he should not feel the pain. But then after a few days he left the body because the condition was deteriorating and no medicine was working. So when he left the body, Dadi Prakash Mani gave this message to Baba and asked Baba, Baba, should we bring the body to Abu? Because he died in Bombay. And that Baba said, no, cremate him there, cremate the body there itself. And then everyone thought that Baba has said to cremate the body there, so let us take many photographs of the body, so that at least we can show to Baba about his stage at the end and all that. And Sister Manohar Dadi, she brought so many photographs in front of Baba to show to Baba, because Baba said, okay, cremate him there, and became so detached. And then as she opened her that envelope to show the photos, Baba said, no. Baba didn't want to see the photos. How close that soul was to Baba. But Baba himself was going beyond. So what is the use of looking at photographs of, all these things, dead body, how the procession, everything, so many photographs. But Baba was completely beyond. So from that, we could realize how beyond Baba is. Baba didn't say anything. Otherwise, somebody can say, what, see photo of dead body, that it can, such words can be spoken. Baba said, no, Baba knows. Baba knows. These were his words. Because as if like a Trikal Darshi, father, the knower of three aspects of time, even though Baba wasn't there, but then Baba knows. So he didn't show any interest of looking at those photographs also. So otherwise some people due to attachment, they say, oh please, and then start crying and this and that, you know, so many things can happen. But then how Baba's stage already become detached. So in the year 1968, we could feel Baba completely detached. And then 6 months before Baba left the body, Baba used to tell a lot, the child, children, even this body, you know, this one will leave the body. This body also is perishable. This one can die. But your connection is with Shiva Baba. And Baba used to see his angelic form. The trans messengers used to see his angelic form. And they used to also see how that angelic, the corporeal form is coming closer to the angelic form. Dadi Gulzar was an expert trans messenger in this. Because she was the first soul to get vision of subtle regions. Before that, in the yajna, whatever visions everybody got, they were visions of maybe Sri Krishna, heaven, destruction, golden age, and Paramdham, all that. But not subtle regions. Dadi Gulzar was the first soul to get vision of subtle regions, and that too, Almighty Baba, you know, one trans messenger brought the message that a few souls should be in complete silence for 8 days, and Baba will show something new, you know, reveal something new. And Dadi Gulzar was very young, you know, she came to Baba when she was just 9 years old. So she was also one of them. And for 8 days, total isolation they were. Even in the midst of the whole gathering, they were made to stay in a different place. They were given just white food. Means no masala in that food, but just rice and dal and also some sabji, very light. And that's all. And for 8 days in complete silence. And at that time, Dadi Gulzar got this vision of subtle regions. She saw that there was a big, like a world of light. Paramdham is golden red light, but this light was like silvery light, very silvery light. And like thousands of moons put together. The light of those moons, you know, you have one moon and you can feel the silvery light in the sky or in the atmosphere. But what if there are thousands of moons and their light? You know, you see these bulbs also, their silvery light, and how that feeling comes. This is physical anyway, but that was angelic. It wasn't some bulb burning and the light of that was experienced. No, it was all self-effulgent light. Like Paramdham is golden red, and in that golden red world, you don't see a few bulbs which are giving that light. The whole element is golden red in color. So subtle region is that experience. And then she saw the angelic form of Brahma Baba. But she was like taken aback, because she had never seen that form of Baba in light, Brahma Baba in light form, all light and transparent. You know, this is opaque body. So this opaque body, you can't see what is inside. But in X-ray, you see what is inside. But then, all the body of light, of course, in the body of light, also there is, you don't see the systems of the body inside, but then just light. Just the outer figure was visible and made of light. The face was very, very clear. So from that she could make out that it is Brahma Baba. So, but then she was taken aback, because it was something very strange for her, something new for her. And then she came back. And then she went to Baba and said, asked Baba, gave this information to Baba, Baba, I got this experience. It was your form, standing form, but all light, light, light. I could see nothing but light, but your face was very distinct. So Baba, then Baba was also curious. Baba asked her, why didn't you ask him, who are you? Why didn't you ask him, who are you? She said, Baba, I didn't think of that because I was a little bit taken aback. It was something strange for me. So then Baba said, okay, go again. Sit in that stage and go again. Maybe you will be able to visualize it again. And this time when you visualize again, ask him, who are you? Because same figure down and up. So she got the courage because she got Srimat now to ask. So the courage came. And then again she got that same experience and she asked him, who are you? And so that angelic form said, I am the perfect form of Brahma Baba. And after Brahma Baba attains perfection, he will become this one. So like Baba pointed out to his own figure. And then how she used to see Brahma Baba's form, which could be corporeal, and the angelic form, light form, coming so close to each other, coming close to each other. And Baba used to tell her, go to the subtle regions and just find out how close I am to the subtle region, to the subtle form. And she used to come back, Baba, you are getting closer, closer, closer. You are getting closer to that subtle form. And of course, the day Baba became avyakt, she did experience that how that form is merged in the angelic form and became just one. And of course, Baba had left the body, so physical body was there, but Baba was in the angelic form. And then Dadi Prakashmani was here. And so Dadi Prakashmani didn't know what to do. I mean, what step to take next? Because it was all of a sudden, you know, never expected that Baba would leave the body. And she used to go into trance, no, Gulzar Dadi. So Dadi told her, please go to the subtle regions and you already see the angelic form of Brahma Baba and go and find out and ask Baba, Baba, why did you leave us? And what to do next? You know, we need your instructions. And this is why we say so. So when she went, she saw only one figure, the angelic form of Brahma Baba. And how she saw double light here, no? Two, the soul of Brahma Baba shining and the soul of Shiv Baba also. Because now Bab Dada had become like combined. Before she used to see Brahma Baba in a separate form and Shiv Baba she used to also see separate. You know, she would see. But now when she went, she saw both together in the forehead. She could feel the light. And then she asked Baba, Baba, why did you leave us and go away? Baba said, who says I have left you? I have not left you. I am with you, but I have just changed my room and my costume. In Hindi, it's very beautifully phrased, kamra or kapda. Kamra means room and kapda means costume, clothes. So I have just changed my room and my costume, my dress. But I haven't left you. It's just like going from one room to another room and then putting another costume, you know. So that's what it is. And therefore, I haven't left you. And she brought this message to Baba, that Baba is saying, I haven't left you, I've just changed my room and my costume. But Dadi didn't understand, you know. It wasn't very clear, what does Baba mean by that. And then again she said, now go again, after some time, and ask Baba, Baba, what is to be done now? And how will this yagya run? Tell that also. And then she went to Baba and again that same experience. And Baba said that Baba will come, Bab Dada will come and meet the children. How will Bab Dada come to meet the children? Again, a very vague expression. So, and then after that, Baba said, tell Prakashmani Dadi to decide in which chariot I should come. I will descend. Because before Shiva Baba would come in the body of Brahma Baba. And we could very clearly understand that now Shiv Baba is in Brahma Baba's body. Because we could feel, you know, the light stage of Brahma Baba, so light, and such powerful drishti, and such powerful voice, like it's the almighty authority speaking. And so Baba said to her, go and ask Dadi Prakashmani that she should decide in which chariot I should come. So, no, it was Dadiji, because she was the one to whom like Baba had willed through drishti and hands. And she was in front of Baba. So Dadi Prakashmani, whom else she could decide. So she said, let Gulzar Dadi be the instrument. And therefore after that, how on 21st of January, after the body was cremated in the evening, Bap Dada came in the body of Dadi Gulzar. And then Dadiji had told Gulzar Dadi to also tell Baba how the yajna will run now after this. So Baba gave the message, Baba will come and tell this in the Murli. This is what Baba said. And then the Murli of 21st of January 1969 is that Murli in which Baba has answered all the questions. At least 8-10 points there are of how this yajna will run now. How Baba said that Shiv Baba and Brahma Baba will become like the backbone, and the Shaktis will be in the front. Then Baba said the sun and the moon will become invisible. Shiv Baba and Brahma Baba, sun and the moon. And the stars will shine in the sky of the earth. You know, very, very poetic. The stars will shine, just like if when there is no sun, no moon, how at night the stars look so beautiful. When the sun is there, the stars are still there, but you can't see the stars, no, because of the sun. And when it is full moon, then also you can't see the stars, because the light of the moon covers the stars. So very often when you see the full moon is very bright, you can't see stars. Only when there's no sun, no moon, then the stars look so beautiful in the sky. Of course, there should be no clouds. So in Mount Abu, we get very good view of the clouds. Do you all watch up to see the clouds? Because I've been to England, I've been to many countries. Everything, that the sky is always so cloudy. But here the sky is so clear, you can see the clear sky. And at night also you can see all the stars. So Baba said that the stars will shine in the sky of the world. And then because she took a long list of questions, no? So Baba said, Baba will answer in the Murli. And then the next point Baba said was, because Dadi asked Baba, what will we do in Madhuban now? Because when children used to come to Madhuban, Baba was the main attraction. Mama, Baba, and of course Didi was there, Didi Manmohini. So who will come to Madhuban? And then Baba gave the Srimad that from now onwards, keep training programs for kumaris, for kumars, for teachers, for mothers, for couples, for brothers, training program, bhattis. And that's why bhattis started in Madhuban only after Baba became aware. Before that, Baba was the main attraction. From morning till night, with Baba only. Amrit Vela with Baba, Murli class, then sometime breakfast with Baba, lunch with Baba, dinner with Baba, going to the mountains with Baba, playing with Baba, you know, everything. Baba was Baba. Everything was Baba. How Baba used to entertain. But then, of course, the souls used to get that feeling of power from Baba, being in Baba's company. But so in the year 1968, just 6 months before Baba left the body, we could feel the difference, how Baba had become angelic. become so light. Like that, Didi Sudesh was saying, no, I just touched Baba's hand, so light, as if no bones at all, you know, so soft. So that was the feeling. And then, so in that Murli, Baba gave all the, you know, points of how this yajna will run. And then Baba said something very interesting, that up to now, the service which had taken place was just at the speed of an ant. Ant speed, you know, how an ant walks. What must be the speed of an ant? And now, the service will take place at bird speed. Again, rhyming words in Hindi. It's like chiti, kichal, or vihang marg. Chiti marg and vihang marg. Vihang is a bird. It flies very fast. And an ant, its speed and that fast bird speed, what a big contrast. And Baba said, now service will happen at that speed, bird speed. And then we saw how so many souls at that time got visions of angelic Brahma Baba. Just like at the beginning, souls got visions of Krishna and Brahma Baba. You know, they would see Krishna in the vision, and then the one who would see the vision would try in the vision itself to go close to Krishna, and then Krishna would go far away, and they would look for Krishna, and Krishna would be far away, and he would point out, because Brahma Baba would appear there, and would point. Krishna would point out, if you want to meet me, go to him. I can meet you only if you go to him. So this was the beginning visions. But in 69, after Baba became aware, so many got visions of angelic Brahma Baba. I also got this vision. Means Baba's children got, but even new ones got, but Baba's children, so many got this vision. I remember the vision I got in 69, you know, Baba left the body on 18th of January 1969, about 9 o'clock at night. And I was studying in my last year of college. I was in BSc, Bachelor of Science. So it was my last year. And I went to the center that evening, it was Saturday evening. And because I used to go to the center, attend class or give class or lecture or exhibition, you know, explain on the exhibition. And I finished, I went at 8 o'clock, I went home. My lucky home was very close to the center in Bombay. So I went home, and that was it, because then Sunday morning we go to the center. I was a student studying in college. So Sunday morning when I went to the center, I was shocked. Why? Because I hardly saw anybody at the center. Usually Sunday morning means lots of hustle bustle, you know, because all students who cannot come on weekdays, they come on Sundays. So it's a holiday, and therefore they come, and we have a big class and vogue and everything. But when I went there, an old lady was sitting in the meditation room, you know, one in the classroom, just 2-4 people, that's all. And I said, what happened? Where is everybody? Where is Dadiji? Where are the seniors? Because in Bombay, many seniors would stay. They would all come and stay in Bombay. So there's everybody. And someone was there, she said, Baba has left the body and everyone has gone to Mount Abu. I said, what? Everyone gone to Mount Abu and Baba has left the body? Because as they got the news, some took taxis, some got the train at night, 11 o'clock train, midnight train, whatever trains. So they, whatever vehicle they got, they just came to Mount Abu. So many came. So many went, and Bombay means all the seniors were there. So they all went. And so hardly anybody at the center, some students also must have gone. So I also wanted to go. But then I had my exams to appear. It was Monday. You know, Monday was my preliminary exams for appearing for my final year in Bachelor of Science degree. So I couldn't go because next year I had to appear for exam. But I went and sat in meditation. And as I sat in meditation, I became so light. Because first of all, when I heard this news, it was like a, definitely a big shock for me. And I felt, you know what I felt at that time? As if this earth is going to separate. My feet started trembling, my legs started trembling. And I looked up and I felt that the ceiling is going to break down. And this world is going to come to an end. This was my feeling at that time. And I started trembling also. And then I remembered that Baba, Brahma Baba, had told me, he had actually written a letter to me when I was in my second year of college, because my family members were telling me to go for medicine, become a doctor, and I didn't know what to do. But Baba knew me very well, because I used to come to Madhuban and Baba used to come to Bombay, and he had great hopes in me. Because I used to speak in English, I was studying in a convent school, English medium, and so I had recited many poetries in front of Baba, even giving lectures in front of Baba. So Baba used to always say that, child, you're very good in English. Baba, you become more good, more clever, and Baba will send you abroad. Baba will send you abroad, because Baba wants hands who can speak English. You know, whenever Baba used to tell the dadis that you have to serve the world, you have to go abroad, the dadis would say, Baba, but we don't know English. I remember Manohar Dadi saying once, Baba told her, you have to go outside other countries and serve. She said, Baba, but I don't know English. Even Dadi Janki, even Avyak Bab Dada, when Baba told her that you have to go to London, she said, Baba, but I don't know English, because only if you know English you can serve there. I don't know English. So Baba would tell them, don't worry, child. You don't have to know English for that. There will be many interpreters for you who will interpret you. So you don't have to learn English in order to serve them. So, but then when Baba would see me, he would say that Baba will send you abroad to serve. So when Baba became awake, and I was in my last year of college, I didn't go for medicine, because Baba wrote a letter to me that, child, Baba wants you to become a spiritual doctor and serve the world. Because I asked in the letter, Baba, should I go for medicine? Baba, what should I do? So Baba used to reply. So in 67, Baba wrote a letter back to me saying, Baba wants you to become a spiritual doctor and serve the world. So I gave up this aim of going for medicine. And I just did my graduation. And so when I was in my last year of graduation, Baba left the body. And immediately a thought came in my mind. Baba, I didn't fulfill your promise. I didn't fulfill your wish. Because Baba wishes that you become a spiritual doctor and serve the world. And I said, Baba, I didn't fulfill your wish and I'm still studying. And Baba, you're gone. I didn't know that Baba will come in the angelic form and this. I thought destruction will take place. That was the only thought which came in my mind. So I sat in meditation and I'm speaking to Brahma Baba, like Baba in front of me. And I said, Baba, you're gone. I haven't fulfilled your wish. And immediately I got such a beautiful vision of angelic Brahma. So beautiful. And Baba like blessed his, you know, put his hand on my head. And Baba said, I haven't gone. I am with the children. I am with you. And you have to fulfill Baba's wish. These were the words I felt at that time. I haven't gone. I'm with you. You have to fulfill Baba's wish. And immediately I felt so relaxed, so relaxed. Otherwise, I'd become so tense, you know, like tense means not afraid, but then, oh, I didn't fulfill Baba's wish. And after that, I became so light. I could feel my stage also in that angelic state. So light, totally free from everything. And that gave me so much courage to complete my graduation. But then I decided after this, no more studies. I want to surrender to Baba. And then, of course, I came to Madhuban, because at that time, Bhatti's training programs had started in Madhuban. So I was in one of the trainings from May 15 to June 15, 1969. And all the seniors who are now in Baba's Yagya, Asha Ben, Aarti Ben, Chandrika Ben, you know, all these seniors now who are sub-zone in charges and all. So I was in that grade. We were only 30 Kumaris. We were Kumaris at that time. I was just finished college. All had finished their college studies. And we came to Madhuban for the training. And all the Dadis were our teachers. Dadi Janki was our teacher. Dadi Chandramani, all the Dadis. Because when the service started in India after coming from Karachi, Baba sent everybody outside to serve. Baba didn't want any seniors, any Dadis, any Yagya, old children to be here. Baba wanted them to be out. Although they were actually not wanting to go. You know Dadi Janki's experience? Because every day Baba was sending someone or the other to go on service. Because invitations were coming. And Dadi Janki's turn was next. So Dadi shares her experience that day in the morning Murli class, Dadi, usually she would sit right in front. And she would always nod, you know, always nod in the Murli. So, but that day she was so afraid because Baba would send her out for service. So she went and sat in one corner, you know, hiding herself. So Baba wouldn't see her. And then Baba said, "Where is Janak?" Baba is always called her Janak. "Where is Janak?" And there she is sitting there, sitting right in the corner of, you know, near the wall, like this. So Baba said, in Hindi, Baba said, "Chal, ye bakri dekho, bakri. Look at this goat." Because, you know, usually goats are so afraid all the time. They are shaking. So look at this goat. She is so afraid to go outside. When will you become a lioness? Aren't you a lioness or you want to remain a goat? And Dadi says at that time she got so much strength, you know. When will you become a lioness? And Baba said, "Come in the front." Like Dadi brings everybody in the front. So he says, "I got this message from Baba, like, tell them to come in the front, then they'll get more strength. So Baba called me to come in and sit in the front. Why have you left your seat?" So she also tells everybody, "Why have you left your seat? Come and sit in the front." And then Baba told her, "Are you afraid? Aren't you a lioness?" She said, "Yes, I'm a lion." "Are you afraid?" "No." And the moment she said, "No, and I'm like a lioness," the courage she got, and then how Baba sent her to many places, that's another story. But then, at that beginning, Baba sent all the Dadis outside. But when Baba became Avyat, Baba called all the Dadis to Madhuban. Because now, the stars are going to shine in the sky of the world, no? Brahma Baba, Shiv Baba become angelic. And therefore the Dadis were our teachers. And how much they used to inspire us. So, we, many sisters who came for the training, we didn't have that aim that we will finish our studies, we won't study anymore and we'll go and surrender. We thought, okay, training means training because it was announced all the who have completed the education or who have done some degree, they are invited to this training. And we were just 30 Kumaris, only 30. 30 is nothing. But that time 30 was also a big thing. This Pandav Bhavan, that upstairs training center had just been constructed. So we were there in that training center. Our classes were there, dinner, our meals there. We didn't come down also. All the time in the training center with our classes and Amrit Vela and food, everything there. And Baba came 4 times. In 1 month, 4 times, every week Baba would come and Baba would give drishti to everyone, blessing to everyone. Everyone, drishti, blessing, toli, just to the Kumaris. You know, you can imagine how much sustenance we got at that time. And then but Baba never mentioned that now you have to go to any center, but just 5 days or 1 week after 3 weeks, in the last week, when Baba came, Baba asked everybody, "Now, what have you decided? Who has decided to go to a center?" So at first nobody raised their hand because we'd all come from home, no? And I also come from my home. So nobody raised their hand. Then Baba said, "If you all decide to go to the center, any center, at least for 1 month, Baba will give you a prize." The Baba speaks normally about giving prize. Everybody raised their hand, even I raised my hand. Because first I thought I will go for a little higher education. I wasn't very sure of what I would do in the future. But then when Baba said, "Baba will give you a prize if you go to a center at least for 1 month," so I raised my hand. And I remember after that, never thought of going back home or going for higher education. From there onwards, our results came in Madhuban. Our examinations, the results came in Madhuban. Because we finished the exams and just came to Madhuban. But what I'm trying to say is that how Baba inspired us and how this yajna went forward, and today we are seeing that how at not only bird speed, but I think much higher than that, how Baba is doing his task of world establishment, golden age establishment, and we are the instrument souls for that. So how souls used to get visions of angelic Brahma. And now Baba says at the end, your visions will be seen to the world. You know, whenever I go in the east, east means east and west. So in east there are so many statues of gods and goddesses, many, many statues. And in the west there are statues of angels. So I once thought that at the end souls will get visions. In the east they will get visions of deities. Baba says, "You are those personal deities, the deities of those devotees, the bhagats, and the people will get visions of you." But in the west, people will get visions of angels. We will be as angels there. Because you go anywhere in Europe, in America, I mean many places anyway, you go, how you have angels. Everywhere angels, angels, angels. So from where have these angels come? Who are these angels? Baba says, "It's you." So our visions will be seen at the end in the form of angels and deities. Because the devotees are waiting for us. Not our physical form, that vision will not be shown to them. But our angelic form and our deity form. Vision will come in front of the deities. And then they will feel that yes, their bhakti has completed. And how their personal god or their deity is now invoking them, and it will be time to return home. And Baba says at the end, the unlimited renunciation will come. Definitely it will come. It will come because the situation will be such that you will not be able to keep any attachment. It will be of no use keeping attachment to anything because nothing will stay. Everything will be destroyed anyway. So the renunciation will come, the disinterest will come first, and then they'll be able to renounce. But then it will be too late, and the mind will go only in objects and people. But those who have had the remembrance for a long time of their personal God, they will get visions of their deities or angels, and then how they'll be able to fly. But of course, Baba says, they will get the punishment. So who are us? Who are we? We are those torchbearers, we are those lights, we are those angels or those deities who will be seen in visions by the devotees. So we have to practice that stage now itself. Sometimes do you feel that you are an angel giving light to the world? Do you feel that? Those who feel that, raise your hand. Not all? Yeah. So sometimes Baba says, sit on top of the globe and give light to the world. Because you can give light to the world on top of the globe only if you are in an angelic form, not in physical form. Physical form you can't go to the top of the globe. So in an angelic form, with Shiv Baba giving you the Sakash and you giving to the world. So how to experience that angelic stage? In a second it should be experienced. Like Baba says, you remove one costume and put on another dress, another costume. It is so easy. But only thing is that the costume shouldn't be tight. If your dress is tight, then it will be difficult to take off and put on another one. So this physical body is our costume. It should be not tight. And how does it become tight? When we are body conscious. So Baba says, practice being soul conscious, soul conscious, soul conscious, detachment, detachment, going beyond in a second. And in this way we can become light. And at the end, it should take us only 1 second, because that will be our last exam, last test, only a 1 second. Only then we can become angelic and return. So that practice is needed. In a long time practice. And Baba has been saying everything will happen suddenly. It won't be told to you beforehand. So suddenly, and secondly Baba says, ever ready, nothing should be remembered. And thirdly Baba says, long time practice. These are the three necessities or three essential steps for becoming an angel. So keeping that in mind, the practice. In a second, go beyond. Come, let us practice that, okay? For the next 15 minutes. In a second, I can go beyond. And become light. I focus my thoughts at the center of my forehead. I am there, seated on my throne. I, the immortal soul, the imperishable soul, the eternal soul, I have changed many costumes. And even now, in a second, I can go beyond this costume of the body. And put on an angelic costume of light. I am double light. Light in form and light in weight. I can fly in a second. I see myself in my angelic costume. I am also surrounded by light. I'm totally free. I am light. My father is also light. I am equal to my father. Baba has made me like him. I can fly with Bap Dada. As I become like him, all my physical bondages are left behind. I am free. No bodily being will be remembered. No physical objects will be remembered. Just Baba and me. I can visualize myself in my angelic dress in the world of angels and Bap Dada in the angelic form. Bap Dada in the angelic form is waiting for me in the subtle regions so that I can become like him and we fly together to the soul world. For that, I have to become complete. I have to become perfect. I visualize my perfect form. how light and detached I am. I am surrounded by light. I can give visions of my angelic form to the distressed souls.